StreamerBot explained commands. Today we'll be learning about commands. Commands are a way for your viewers to interact with your stream via the chat. Some of the more popular commands that you'll see around are uptime, followage, and lurk. These commands are typed in chat and you'll usually get a response. In StreamerBot, a command is just a trigger, and the result will be an action. We have covered triggers and actions in previous videos. So let's learn how to create a command. You can do it one of two ways. You can go into the commands tab, right click and press add, or you can do it via the trigger configuration. When you add your command trigger, it will say create command. Either way, we're going to end up on this screen. There are a lot of things on this screen, so allow me a moment to guide you through it. Here is where you can give your command a name. Note, this isn't the command, it's just a name so you can recognize it or you can search by it. Under that is a mode dropdown. This will allow you to swap between basic or regex. Then you have the enable checkbox. This will control if the command is enabled or not. The include checkbox controls if it will be part of the get commands subaction when it's used. Here is a location setting. There are three values here. Start, meaning start of the message. Exact, meaning it must be exactly what you've said. And anywhere, meaning it just needs to be somewhere in the message. Then we have the commands box. This is where you'll add your commands. You can add multiple commands, just put them on a new line. You can also add your command to a group. This allows for better organization. Then we have a couple more options. If ticked, ignore bot account means your logged bot account won't be able to trigger it. Ignore internal messages means any messages sent by StreamerBot won't trigger it. Persist user counter means StreamerBot will keep track of how often a user uses it. Persist counter means StreamerBot will keep track of how often it gets used. And case sensitive means that the casing is important in the command. Next to that, we have the source box. Here, we control where the command can come from. And as you can see, Twitch message is ticked by default, but you can change this by ticking and unticking the sources you want. At the bottom, we have cooldown options. Cooldown is a way to control how often a command can be used. We can do it globally or per user. It's important to note that here the time is in seconds. On the right, we have all the permission settings. At the top, we have grant type, which can be allow or deny. Then underneath, we have our section where we can change a user's permissions. This can be done on a group level or a user level. If the second box here is empty, then the grant type applies to all users. If it's not empty, it applies to the users or groups within that box. So to make a mod only command, all we need to do is set the grant type to allow and put the moderators in the allowed box. An easy way to make a broadcaster only command is just to set the grant type to declined. If you're controlling user permissions, all you need to do is switch to the user tab and then add the users you want, which is fairly easy. Just press add users and search for the users. You will see the name and the platform so you know exactly who is who. It's important to note also that broadcasters are immune to both permissions and to cooldowns. With all this information, you should now be able to create your own commands in StreamerBot and know how to use them to their full potential. Thank you for watching. If you have any other questions or need any more assistance, please feel free to reach out in Discord. Link for that is in the description. Also, you can check out some of these other videos to teach you more about Streamer.bot.